chosen generation. We've been called for to show his excellence. Hey, all I require for life, God has given me, and I know who I am. We are a chosen generation. We've been called for to show his excellence. All I require for life, God has given me, for I know who I am. I know who God says I am, what he says I am, where he says I'm at. I know who I am, I know who God says I am, what he says I am, where he says I'm at. I know who I am. I'm working in power, I'm working miracles. We've been called for to show his excellence. All I require for life, God has given me, and I know who I am. We are a chosen generation. We've been called for to show his excellence.
All I require for life, God has given me.
And he that has not the Son of God has not life. And we know that the Son of God is come and hath given us an understanding that we may know him that is true. And we are in him that is true. Even in his Son Jesus Christ. This is the true God and eternal life. The Bible declares, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. And whosoever believes that Jesus is the Christ is born of God. Therefore, it is clear that a man must receive Jesus into his heart as the Lord of his life to be born of God with the nature of love.
Na asili ya upendo.
Then and then,
na hapo ndipo,
only that he become a member of God's family,
ndipo atakapoweza kuwa sehemu ya familia ya Mungu,
and a partaker of the inheritance of saints in light.
Na mshiriki wa urithi wa Mungu katikati ya watakatifu.
Now to Brother Frank.
Na kwa Brother Frank sasa.
Sister Lucy.
Na Dada Lucy.
Do you hear?
Yeah, mnasikia.
In the presence of this congregation,
kwa mbele ya kundi hili,
we affirm your faith in Jesus Christ as the Lord of your life.
Kama ni Bwana wa maisha yenu.
To Brother Frank, if yes, say yes I do.
Kama ni kweli sema ndio na ni kweli.
If yes, say yes I do.
Kama ni hivyo ndio sema ndio.
Upon public profession of your faith,
baada kukiri kwa wazi kwa imani yenu,
you have made known to all men,
umefanya kujulikana kwa watu
wote, Jesus Christ of Nazareth,
kwamba Yesu Kristo wa Nazareth,
is your Lord and Savior,
ni Bwana na Mwokozi wenu,
and that you are born again,
na kwamba mmezaliwa mara ya pili,
an experience,
hali,
without which no man shall see the kingdom of God as Jesus said,
ambao pasipo hiyo hakuna mtu anayeweza kuona ufalme wa Mungu.
I submit to you therefore,
nina
by the word of the Lord,
kwa neno la Bwana,
that a miracle took place
kama muujiza umetokea,
when you made Jesus the Lord of your life,
ulipomfanya Yesu kuwa Bwana wa maisha yako,
you received eternal life,
ulipokea uzima wa milele,
and became one with Jesus Christ,
na mkawa mmoja pamoja na Yesu Kristo.
Scripture from 1 Corinthians chapter 6 17, verse 17 says,
Biblia katika kitabu cha Wakorintho wa kwanza sura ya 17 mstari wa 17 inasema,
you are one spirit with him,
kwa maana ni roho moja pamoja naye.
In Ephesians chapter 5 verse 30,
katika kitabu cha Efeso 5 mstari wa 30
it says,
inasema,
you are a member of his body,
kwa maana wewe ni mshiriki wa mwili wake,
of his flesh,
wa nyama zake,
and of his bones,
na wa mifupa yake.
When two born again believers come before God,
wale waliozaliwa mara ya pili wakija mbele za Mungu,
to be joined together,
kuunganishwa pamoja,
as husband and wife,
kama mume na mke,
a miracle also takes place by their union.
Pia unatokea
the same power,
nguvu ile ile,
that joining with Jesus Christ,
ambayo ilikuunganisha na Yesu Kristo,
also
pia
joins you both together as well,
inawaunganisha pamoja pia.
Paul the apostle,
Mtume Paulo,
in Ephesians chapter 5 and 32,
katika kitabu cha Efeso 5 mstari wa 32,
calls this union a mystery,
anaita huu umoja ni siri,
and say,
na anasema,
but as speak concerning Christ,
kwamba naongea kuhusu Kristo,
and the church therefore,
na kanisa pia,
the wife,
kwamba mke,
is the object of a husband love,
kwamba yeye ndio kitu cha upendo wa mume,
even as the church,
kama vile ilivyo kanisa,
is the object of Christ's love,
ndio udhihirisho wa upendo wa Kristo.
On the other hand,
kwa namna nyingine,
the wife should reverence her husband,
kwa mke amheshimu mumewe,
even as the church,
kama vile kanisa,
should reverence Christ,
linapotakiwa kumheshimu Kristo.
Thus this union,
kwamba umoja huu,
is not merely a legal contract,
sio tu kwamba ni mkataba wa kisheria,
but a love centered institution,
lakini taasisi iliyoundwa katika upendo.
For this cause,
kwa sababu hiyo,
shall a man leave his father and mother,
mtu atamwacha baba na mama yake,
and shall be joined unto his wife,
na ataunganishwa na mama yake,
and the two shall become one,
na wawili watakuwa mmoja.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana asifiwe.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana asifiwe.
Lucy Nicholas Kayombo, as your wife,
kuwa
to love her as a church, sorry, to love her even as Christ loves the church,
kumpenda kama vile Kristo anavyolipenda kanisa,
to protect her and care for her,
kumlinda na kumtunza,
to stand with her in the faith of the gospel of Jesus Christ,
katika imani ya Yesu Kristo,
in health,
katika afya,
prosperity,
mafanikio,
joy, and also to stand with her in the faith of the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ against sickness, poverty, and death all your lives. Don't we have a microphone for them? I want us to hear them well.
He does.
Can you say it so that I can hear you, so that I can hold you to it?
Yes, I do.
Thank you. Then please talk to her and make this profession of your faith. Could you put the microphone in his mouth? Say aye.
Aye.
Put your names, please.
Frank Romesh Nkya.
According to the word of God.
According to the word of God.
And the statement of my vows.
And the statement of my vows.
Hereby join myself to you.
Hereby join myself to you.
To be your husband.
To be your husband.
From henceforth.
From henceforth.
We shall be one.
We shall be one.
Hallelujah.
Amazing.
Please turn and face me again. Now to the bride. Do you, Sister Lucy Waluhi Nicholas Kayombo, do you take Frank Nkya as your husband, submitting yourself to him as the head of this union, to stand with him in the faith of the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, in health, prosperity, and joy, and also to stand with him in the faith of the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, against sickness, poverty, and death all your lives?
Yes, I do.
Thank you. Then please turn to him and make this profession of your faith. Okay. Say aye. Put your names there.
Aye. Aye, Lucy Kayombo.
Mimi Lucy Kayombo.
According to the word of God.
According to the word of God.
And the statement of my vows.
And the statement of my vows.
Hereby join myself to you.
Hereby join myself
to you. To be your wife.
To be your wife.
From henceforth.
From henceforth.
We shall be one. Hallelujah. The ring is a never-ending circle made out of precious metal that indicates an unending love. It is a special gift of trust. It's talking of engagement. And a seal of the vows that you both have made to each other today. May I have the bridegroom, please? Please take this ring. Put it at the tip of our fingers. And please say after me. So with this ring, I did wed. I give it as a token of my love.
And my faith.
I believe with all my heart that this is for all time. It is the seal of my vows to you. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. This guy has no experience in speaking to you. May I have the groom's ring, please? Praise the Lord. Please take this ring. Put it at the tip of his finger. And please say after me. So with this ring,
I did wed.
I give it as a token of my love.
And
my faith.
I
believe with all my heart.
And
this is for all time.
It is the seal of my vows to you.
In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
For as much as Sister Lucy and Brother Frank have consented together in holy wedlock, and I witness the same before God and this congregation, and hereto have pledged their love and faith to each other by the giving and receiving of rings, I pronounce in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth that they are husband and wife from this day forward. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'd like everybody to please stretch forth their hands towards them and pray for the newlywed. Pray concerning their marriage. That this marriage shall be fruitful. They are fruitful in their minds, fruitful in their bodies.
Wana matunda katika miili yao, matunda katika ndoa yao.
They have come together to be a strong force in the kingdom of God.
Wamekuja pamoja kuwa force kubwa katika ufalme wa Mungu.
They will be an example of marriage.
Watakuwa mfano wa ndoa.
And people will see them.
Na watu watawaona.
And give glory to the name of God.
Na watoe utukufu kwa jina la Mungu.
Father, we thank you, Lord.
Baba tunakushukuru.
We worship you.
Tunakuabudu.
We bless your name.
Tunalibariki jina lako.
We thank you for these ones that have come together.
Nao bariki kwa ajili ya wale waliokuja pamoja.
Brother Frank and Sister Lucy.
Kaka Frank na kaka Lucy. Dada Lucy.
Father, we thank you.
Tunakushukuru.
Because together,
kwa sababu pamoja,
the kingdom of God will move forward.
Ufalme wa Mungu utaenda mbele.
Father, Lord, this marriage will last.
Ndoa hii itadumu.
They are fruitful and productive.
Wanazaa matunda
in their bodies and in their minds.
Katika miili yao na katika akili zao.
In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Katika jina la Yesu Kristo.
No plan of the enemy will prosper concerning them.
Hakuna mpango wa adui utakaofanikiwa katika maisha yao.
Whatever they put their hands to do, they prosper.
Na chochote wanachoweka mkono kufanya watafanikiwa.
We thank you, Father, because their steps shall not slide.
Tunakushukuru kwa maana hatua zao hazitateleza.
As your word has said, the steps of the righteous are ordered. Their steps are ordered in the right direction.
Hatua zao zimeongozwa katika sehemu sahihi.
And together they will do exploits in the kingdom of God.
They will
grow from strength to strength. Father, Lord, I bless them in your name.
And
bless them with your word. Bless them with prosperity. Divine health. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you.
Baba tunakushukuru.
We worship you. In Jesus' name.
Katika jina la Yesu. God
bless you.
Mungu awabariki.
Praise the Lord. I just want to admonish you briefly, and Pastor Nkya will come and read the charge to you. Congratulations.
Amen.
Do that. Frank. Welcome to marriage. In this school that you have just attended, you don't graduate from it. And you keep learning every day. Are you hearing? If you want to divorce, you're free. But on one condition. If you want to divorce this woman, or if you want to divorce this man, please make sure. Look at everybody that is here present today. Are you hearing me? Make sure that you invite every one of us. None must be missing. And then make sure. And please watch the clothes we're wearing.
Angalia na nguo ambazo tumezivaa leo.
The color of the clothes.
Na rangi ya nguo zao.
We are putting on the same clothes.
Baba tu tumevaa nguo hizi hizi.
Nothing different.
Hakuna kitu kisiwe kimebadilika.
Please make sure you take the age of everybody that is here present.
Hakikisha unachukua umri wa kila mtu aliyepo.
You must not be older than what we are today.
Haitaki kuwa ana umri mkubwa zaidi ya ilivyo leo.
If you meet this condition, you are free to divorce.
Ukiweza kutimiza masharti yao unaruhusiwa.
But if you cannot meet this condition,
yes, divorce.
So this marriage is forever. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Admonish you to love yourselves. People say marriage is not a bed of roses. But even if it is, don't forget that roses have one of the sharpest thorns. If you lie on that bed, It's possible that one of the tongues may prick you. There's no marriage that has no challenges. But with united strength and making Christ the Lord of your life, you overcome every challenge. Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me? Anytime you have issues, take it to God. Let God settle you. Not necessarily your parents. Take it to God together. And if you need any assistance, come to the church. Lord, we will counsel you according to God's word. Are you hearing me? Well, if you have Christian parents, praise God for them. I know from time to time they will give you advice that will make your marriage last. And such advice, please do not neglect. Are you hearing me? Be your, from today, you do not, your best friend is your wife. Your best friend. If you had one guy, one lady that used to be your best friend, that you do everything together, from today that one has ended. Your husband is not your best friend. Talk to each other more than you talk to any other person. Are you hearing me? And please do not have separate rooms. And no separate beds. If you quarrel, sleep on the same bed. And don't let the bed be too as you know. Amen. If you make God the head of your home, your marriage will stand. And you begin to count the years upon it. May God bless you. May the hand rest upon you. Amen. Now, could you turn to face the crowd before the charges are
revealed?
Let our face be exposed. Thank you. Get closer to her. Could you hold her, please? This guy, you are so experienced in this matter. You may not kiss the bride. Okay, you may kiss the bride. One more time. Do it again. So the camera can capture it. Congratulations. Congratulations. Can we put our hands together? Let's make God come.
Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
This charge is to you, Brother Frank and Sister Lucy. I charge you first of all to consider that your promises to each other are made in the presence of God, who remembers your pledges and helps you by His Spirit in performing them. I admonish you to keep in mind that each of you is the object of Christ's redemption and should neither be neglected nor belittled by the other. Esteem each other as God's gift for mutual aid, comfort, and joy, and as a repository of complete confidence and trust. I encourage you to share willingly your joys and difficulties, your success and challenges, and to be neither conceited by the former nor depressed by the latter.
Wala kunyonyongenyezwa na yale yanayokuja mbele.
Cleave closely to each other.
Shikamaneni pamoja.
In spirit and in truth.
Katika roho na kweli.
That difficulties may be met by united strength.
Kwamba magumu yatakapokuja yakutane na umoja.
And victories by united joy.
Na ushindi pamoja na furaha.
I charge you to make your home.
Na mbele muifanye nyumba yenu.
A place where you will have refuge from the storms of life.
Sema ambapo mtakuwa na kimbilio kutokana na changamoto za maisha.
Not only for yourselves.
Sio kwa nyinyi wenyewe tu.
But also for others who may be your guests.
Lakini kwa wengine pia ambao watakuwa wageni kwenu.
Let it be a haven for the weary.
Acha iwe kuwa mbingu kwa wale ambao wamechoka.
A source of upliftment for the discouraged.
Sehemu ya kunyanyuliwa kwa wale ambao wamekata tamaa.
And a convincing testimony to this cynical world.
Na ushuhuda kwa katika ulimwengu huu wa sasa.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Recognize therefore.
Tambua pia.
The Lord Jesus Christ.
Kama Bwana Yesu Kristo.
As the head of your home.
Kama kiongozi wa familia yenu.
The Lord of your lives.
Bwana wa maisha yenu.
And the personality of your deepest affection.
Na yeye ambaye mnampenda kuliko kila kitu.
As you do.
Ndakapofanya hivi.
He will confirm your marriage by his guidance.
Ataongoza nyumba yenu ataongoza familia yenu.
And will overshadow your home with peace.
Na atafunika familia yenu kwa amani.
I charge you to love the Lord.
Naomba mumpende Bwana.
And to serve him.
Na kumtumikia.
With sincere hearts.
Na mioyo iliyo
thabiti. All the days of your life.
Siku zote za maisha.
Glory be to God.
Utukufu kwa Mungu.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you keep to these things.
Ukishikilia hivi vitu.
You'll be so amazed at the beauty of it all.
Na uzuri
wake. Congratulations once
more.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Right now we are going to give our offerings. So I want each and every one of you to put your hands in your pocket and bring out your offering. Thanksgiving offering, celebrating what God has done, the miracle that has taken place here today. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Choir.
Choir.
I also want to present to you
kuzaliwa kwa njia vyeti vya ndoa
from the United Republic of Tanzania
kutoka katika serikali ya Tanzania.
Sana Frank. Na kama mlivyosema mchungaji amesema maneno mazuri. Sisi na mamako hatuna maneno ya kuongezea pale. Sema tu ilikuwa na maki muda, ilikuwa saa 11:30. Sasa hivi umeshaongezeka umri, huwezi kuwarudisha tena watu umri urudi tena nyuma. Kwa hiyo ile kuachana kuna.
Amina.
Yeah, kuna kabisa.
Amina
kabisa. Hiyo
mwali wetu ni nene.
Yeah, sisi hatuna maneno mengi. Mwali karibu. Wewe ni mtoto wa pili wa mama Aika wa kike.
Amen.
Wewe tunakaribisha sana. Zawadi yetu iko kwenye gari. Tukaona kwa nini tuweke hapa. Tuna microwave ambayo ni nzuri kabisa. Ya kisasa. Ili usichelewe hata ukimwona Frank umechelewa una nani mwenyewe tunaweka vitu vyako pale kwa microwave ili mweze kuwahi kazini. Asante sana. Kama kuna neno kidogo.
Mwali karibu nyumbani.
Amen.
Mwali kuti kwa wakati wote wana. Tunaweza tukaendelea kuleta zawadi. Tujitahidi kwenda na muda kidogo, tuko nyuma ya muda. Zawadi.
Tukikusanyika kwa kile tulichokishuhudia siku ya leo. Kipekee kabisa ni ombi. Watusalimie Lisa and Mrs. Hama kwa kaya toshi. Please. Wow. Makofi tena. Mwanyo lenda wanopie mjeligiri. Keki yule upendaye. Na mimi napenda nitoe hii fursa kwa bibi harusi apate kumlisha bwana harusi keki. Karibu bibi harusi, twende. Aha, kila mmoja tazame hapa. Wow. Ile keki ilegeni shumoja tu. No, wakaka walikuwa wapigi makofi. Wadada alipigi kigirigiri ni mmoja. Sasa tunapokuwa tufanye vizuri zaidi, tunampa wakati mgumu zaidi bwana harusi. Naomba turudie. Tuko tunarudi Yesu, sio? Turudie. Wow. Tende tena. Sipopiga makofi na vigirigiri, hawa tutaishana keki mpaka ishe. Let's go! Wow! Watu mekonea uluma. Hini mesikia kaka mmoja huku. I like that one. Beautiful, right?
Yeah.
Thank you. Take a cake. A piece of cake. Don't take a cake. Take a piece of cake. For the one that you love. It's 7 billion. Try and choose one. And that one, she's here.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
She's special.
Yeah.
What a wonderful night. Please.
And beautiful.
Come on. I want to see you smiling if we're here together. Woo! Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Let's go. Can we dance? Can we sing? We know who we are.
Let's go.
Make sure you're dancing right now.
All I require for life, God has given me, and I know who I am.
We are sisters of heaven. Let me know right now.
You
want to be the best now.
Frank, tunakupenda sana na tunafurahia kwa kile ambacho Mungu amekubariki. Ni muombe rafiki. Ninaomba utoe neno moja tu la shukrani kwa ajili ya siku ya Frank. Frank alizaliwa siku ya leo na leo ni siku ambayo Mungu amempatia mke. Please.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord Jesus. Yes, today is a wonderful day. It's a rock of sharing. Yeah, a great man of God. Vanessa Spear. Yeah. Need to go to the Vanessa Spear.
Thank you so very much. Thank you so very much, right? Ninaitu muhimu sana katika kusanyiko hili. Na yeye ana maneno la kusema. Karibu.
Please, let's go. Yeah. Another one. Tupige makofi mpaka azungumze. Pige makofi.
Happy birthday, my husband. Happy birthday, brother Frank. Happy birthday, man of God.
Yeah.
Happy birthday, my friend.
Yeah.
That's the best one.
Best.
Yes. Only best friend.
Happy birthday, my first flight partner.
Yeah. Wow. Wow. I love
best friend. Yes. Most importantly, my partner in the work of Christ.
Yeah.
I'm very happy and it's an honor to celebrate your birthday today. So we'll pray for you, but I'll pray for you. I've received so much. So I know this is the first year of so many good, great, big, mighty years to come.
Yeah.
I'm here to that. So I love you so much.
Chache sana watu wakilishe upande wa vijana wote, wa baba wote, wa kaka wote, wa yumba wote, wa cha wakilishwa na investment. That's my karibu French akulishe keki. Wow, this is awesome. Thank you. Tupige makofi wakati na Mrs. Frank, please, mshike mkono wakati analishwa. Please, iwe kama amelishwa na familia. This is awesome. This is awesome. Makofi kwao. Makofi kwao. Please, ninaamini pictures natoka vizuri. Ndio. Na, namuomba dada kawakilishe marafiki, ndugu, jamaa wote kwa upande wa saidi ya pili. Aha. They're going like this. Please, Mrs. Jane Lister, Mrs. Jane Frank, here. Makofi kwao. Oh, wait. Sorry. All right, makofi kwao. I like that one. That was awesome, right?
Yes.
Nani anasema mimi sikubali. Lazima nile keki. Just say it. Just say it. Nyesha mkono. Do like this, I'll say it. Tuko wachache, so ni rahisi. Wow, karibu, karibu. Kiwewe, twende,
twende.
Wow, 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 wow. Amebeleza, makofi kwake. Yeye pia anapata nafasi ya kuwakilisha. Oh, anasema nipunguzie hiyo kubwa. Pagina yasema we are giving it. Alright, makofi kwa. Wow. Nafasi ya mwisho ya upendeleo. Moja tu, moja tu. Alright. Kila mtu anongoneza tu. Wow. The one and only Sister Mint of Most High God. She's here for coffee. Wow, thank you. Thank you so very much. Naomba nipate nafasi nyingine upendeleo kutoka kwa maharusi wetu. Waniambie wao watakumbusha nani. Ni moja tu.
Jamani, makofi kwangu.
Makofi, makofi.
Tunashukuru sana. Kati ni tamu. Jamani, anamchukua mke wake. Watakuwa wakicheza kidogo wakirudi kuketi. Na turudi kwenye viti vyetu. Kama keki imekupita usikose.
Look.
muda wetu sio rafiki sana na tusingependa tuchukue muda mrefu sana hapa tukifahamu kwamba maharusi wetu wamechoka tangu asubuhi ndio sasa ratiba yangu inaniambia ni wakati mzuri sasa wa kwenda kupata dina yetu ambayo ni nitamkaribisha Sister Jen tena aombe kwa ajili ya chakula kwa ajili ya chakula yes Amen. Nasema amen, right? Oh, let's get amen. Maharusi wetu tunanyuka sasa. Nitaomba tupite. Maharusi wetu wananyanyuka kwenda kupata chakula, alafu baadaye best man. Alafu kila mmoja atakuwa ama tupite kule. Asante. Bwana harusi anamuomba mkono mke wake, naye anamchukua taratibu namna hiyo. Wakiwa wamependeza na wanang'ara, wanaelekea kupata chakula. Asante sana. Asante, karibu DJ.
Uniongoze kwa huruma zako. Usiku nibariki, siwezi kwenda. Niachua
kuchukua chakula ni wanyanyue. Thank you, Mrs. Helga.
Only you can do what nobody can do. Oh, Dada, sogea uko mbali, sogea.
Great opportunity to thank you for coming and joining us. We are so blessed to be here. Mr. and Mrs. Frank Nkya, we thank you. Thank you. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for this wonderful time. We are blessed. We are protected. And from today, we'll hear testimony from every corner. Thank you for this wonderful wedding. Father, we declare blessings in their life.
Amen.
They are moving from glory to glory.
Yes.
Thank you, dear Heavenly Father, for this wonderful time. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Amen.
God bless you to the kingdom with you. All right.
Tushukuru.
Tushukuru. Laza.
Jamani, on behalf of myself and my beautiful wife, I would like to thank you for taking your time to spend this time with us. Kwamba mjao unajua maisha ya ndoa. Seriously guys, we thank you so much. Ndoa ni tamu. So guys, we love you so much. Thank you. I'm out of work today. So you guys have showed up. It's been a blessing in your life. I'd like to especially thank our maids, Brother Edgar, Mr. Elliot. I would like to thank Chungai, my good friend, mke wake, ambao kwa sehemu kubwa sana wamefanikisha. So kwa leo alitoka huko. But again, I would like to thank the Anets and Mondoka, Daika for the decorations, the hotel for giving us place, the camera crew, Kajalo Metisha Baba.
Thanks, bro.
And everyone who has participated. We wish you a beautiful and tunara kajamasa. Miskumwe mama.